What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I hope you're all having a great weekend. Today's topic, we are going to talk about what I think is the best camera setup for skateboarding. So let's get right into this. If I look a bit sleepy today, that's because I just woke up half an hour ago, but that doesn't matter, we will do this anyway. Okay, here's the thing, in the past I got asked over and over again how I film skateboarding and if I could teach somebody to film skateboarding and just give some tips about how to make a skate video. So this is a new series on this channel called How to Film Skateboarding, or Film Skateboarding, or just Skate Videos. This series on this channel is all about how to film skateboarding. I hope you're interested in that kind of stuff. I noticed a lot of skaters would like to learn how to make better skate videos or film skateboarding, so that's why I'm doing this. I guess today is the first part of the series, and today is all about what I think is the perfect setup for filming skateboarding. I mean camera setup, not skateboard setup. I only have one problem now. As I started filming this video, I realized that I have to show my camera somehow, because I would like to show my camera setup for skateboarding, and I also have to film this video on this camera. So I thought all the clips you see from the skateboard camera setup are going to be cut over this A-roll shot and going to be B-roll. I can't show the camera now because I can't like take this while it's filming. I hope you understand that I don't have a second camera now, so that is the idea. That being said, let's start now by saying one thing. Already the title is a bit wrong, because I think there is no perfect camera setup for skateboarding. People use different setups to get different videos, to get different styles in videos in skateboarding, and you can't say that there is one perfect setup. You might know some skaters like to use VX cameras, some skaters like to use GoPros, even your cell phone works perfect to film skateboarding, and you might know a lot of people like to film skate videos on a cell phone and share the videos then on Instagram. But for the kind of stuff that I do, I think this here is the perfect camera setup for skateboarding. The main part, the brain if you will, of my skateboarding setup is a DSLR. I use a DSLR because I use my Nikon DSLR for everything, and I think it works perfect for everything. That's why I'm using it. I also use it for photos, I use it for filming skateboarding, I use it for making this video, and I use it for everything. I think you got it now. The thing is, there is not one setup that I use here for filming skateboarding, there are actually two. One setup is the wide setup, the fisheye setup, that I use to film lines, that I use to film stairs, tricks, rail tricks, all that kind of stuff. And then is the other setup with my longer lens, which I use to capture B-roll of skateboarding that I can include in street parts later. That's something I also use and something that is necessary, but today I would like to talk about the wide setup, the fisheye setup. And if you do not understand anything now, let me know in the comments below, I can explain everything in further videos. I do not have to explain everything now, but there's just so much to talk about in filming skateboarding, so I will try to keep this simple now. So let's start with my setup now. As I told you, I can't show my camera, but I can show all the other parts. So let's just start with this thing here. This product here is called the Z-Grip, I guess. It's a handle to film skateboarding. This is super handy because if you have your camera attached on here, you can attach your DSLR on here. And this tool allows you to get lower angles in filming skateboarding, because in skateboarding you would always like to get low angles. Here are some examples. That's what you see a lot of beginners do, filming a wide skate video like this, holding the camera like this. If you use a wide lens to film maybe like a line, a skateboarding line, you should always hold the camera. I can stand up and show this, you should always hold the camera like not there, but down there, something down there. If you would like to film skateboarding, get this grip. I think it's only about 20 bucks or something like that on Amazon. It's not very expensive, but it's definitely something I'm using a lot, and I definitely consider getting something like this. The next step, this is not so important, but I'm using a microphone to get better sound quality. And also a cool thing about the Z-Grip, I can easily attach the microphone on top of the grip, and here would be the camera then, and I would plug in the aux cable now in the camera. I already talked about this microphone here, or here is a video where I talk about this microphone. Yeah, it's a great little microphone, not so expensive, and in skateboarding you don't necessarily need a microphone. I think also the thing is, a lot of people like to cut music over their skate videos, so the sound of the skateboarding is not so, let's say, important anymore. But if you would like to get really, you know, like crispy skateboarding sound, good skateboarding sound, you should definitely consider getting a microphone. Then next up we got the Whoop LEDs. You should be familiar with these lens now. Maybe you noticed these lens. I filmed a vlog some days ago where I only use this lens here or here. You know what I'm talking about. This is the super wide lens. I also talked in that video why I use this only for skateboarding, because it's a skateboarding lens. You can use this, and if you stick it on your camera, it's going to be like, I think I should show it one more time here. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. You see, like, that shit is crazy. Like, I'm using the same tripod, same distance from my face, and you can see almost the whole room here. You know what I'm talking about. This is a fisheye lens. Okay, back on the normal lens now. I think you saw the difference. Yeah, this lens, it's not the sharpest lens. It's also not the best lens. This here is the lens I'm going with if I would like to film stairs, if I would like to film a rail or a line. Of course, I use this for filming skateboarding lines. This lens makes everything looking way bigger. Like if you have 10 stairs, this lens makes them super wide. Like then they look maybe like 30 stairs. No, that's not the key here, but it looks big. Everything looks big, and skateboarding looks cool with this lens. Also, photos taken on this lens of skateboarding look cool. Here are some examples. And now I would set up this. I would put my camera in here and then the fisheye in front of it. Here is what the full setup looks like. Bro! It's a skateboarding video. You're feeling fine, your arm?
Yeah.
He will be back in a few days, I guess. Yeah, bro just woke up. When it comes to cameras, I would say I would go with a APS-C size sensor camera, which means not a full frame sensor camera. A full frame is just a bigger sensor. A APS-C sized camera sensor is a smaller sensor that I'm also using. That means that you basically have a smaller body, everything is more compact. And if you have a setup like this, you don't want like a big body in there, like something really heavy. So an Nikon, Canon, Sony camera would work perfectly fine for this. Like a smaller camera, not the big cameras. I would like to say one more thing. If you get a DSLR, try to get a DSLR that shoots at least in 60 frames per second. Because first reason, with 60 frames per second, you can get some nice slow-mo and you can capture the moment better. And you definitely need to get the camera that shoots in 60 frames per second, because otherwise you can't get slow-mo videos. So definitely look out for that. Yeah guys, that was pretty much it. That was what I think is the best camera setup to film skateboarding, or what I use. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I hope you're interested in that kind of content that I'm trying to share here. So if you like this video, smash the like button. No, don't move, one more second. Bye.